Welcome back, everyone, to another Dicon Dissectional production hosted by Deathstroke9. Today we're going to be reacting to something that a lot of people have been requesting recently. Don McLean, Vincent. Alright? Yeah. And here's where I get apprehensive again, because everyone who requested it would be on videos where I'm like, oh, this is so sad, and then they're like, oh, you want a sad song? Here's a sad song. Here's a sad song. So, here's why this interested me. First of all, I'm pretty sure this is the one who sings American Pie, right? I think? Yeah. So, obviously a good singer, storyteller. Yeah, a lot of people have asked me to react to that song. I don't know. I know I've heard the song before. I could do my normal, like, lyrical dissection thing if you want me to for American Pie. Just let me know if you want me to do that, but I will let you know. I've definitely heard the song before. I feel like that's an extremely famous song, but who knows. All right. But anyway, today we're going to be checking out Vincent, which looked interesting because you guys told me that it's about Vincent van Gogh, who was an interesting character, to say the least. I learned a lot about him in school a couple of years ago. And I'm pretty sure he was probably by the end of his life clinically insane. Not entirely sure. He's definitely an artist. And he sacrificed everything for his work. And I think he killed himself. So, fun times. So yeah, if you're new to the channel, hello, my name is Daniel, aka Deathstroke9, and here we react to music. I try to figure out what the music and the lyrics mean to me personally. So yeah, if you enjoy these types of videos, consider subscribing to the channel. And yeah, there's not that much else to say, except I'm excited to check this out. I've got a lyric video version because it had like his paintings in the background, and I felt it'd just be a good way to, I don't know, pay tribute, I guess, in my video. Not really, but a little bit. It's a better tribute video to watch, I guess you could say. So, that's about all I've got to say. Let me look up the lyrics before we begin. Oh, wait, we have a lyric video. All right, let's just start. Don McLean, Vincent, apparently also Starry Starry Night with lyrics, but I didn't see any other thing that said that Starry Starry Night was in the name. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Starry Starry Night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. Starry, starry night, flaming flowers that brightly blaze.
Okay. Maybe they'll listen now. So, did he think that, is this supposed to mean that him, like, ending his own life would be, giving a message? He tried to tell them something. And it's interesting how a lot of his paintings focused on the beauty of nature and the poverty of mankind, almost. It's interesting. All right, let's get going. He has some very, very interesting artwork.
Flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze reflect in Vincent's eyes of china blue. colors changing hue. Morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain,
yeah,
are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. Now I understand.
This is a self-portrait. I'm about to cut his ear off.
What you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now, for they could not love you. But still your love was true. And when no hope was left in sight on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. But I could have told you, Vincent, this world was never meant for one as beautiful as you.
So sad.
Starry, starry night.
Wait, pause it. So he, so he's saying that if he could go back and tell him, then maybe things could have been different. Wow, that is really sad. Okay. Huh. It's interesting that he paid tribute to this artist like this, because, I mean, Vincent van Gogh is, like, very, very way before... yeah. I mean, let's look it up. When was he alive? Or when did Van Gogh die? Eighteen ninety. Vincent van Gogh was a Dutch post-impressionist painter who was among the most famous and influential figures in the history of Western art. In just over a decade, he created about 2,100 artworks, including 860 oil paintings, most of which date from the last 2 years of his life. He shot himself. And his brother Theo, yeah. And he cut off his ear, okay. He suffered from severe depression. He cut off lower part of his left ear with a razor. Apparently 2 years before he died. He created such an enormous body of work in his time. It's like the only release he had. Obviously, we don't know him. But this is a beautiful tribute to Mr. Vincent. Let's keep going.
Full as you. Starry, starry night. Portraits hung in empty halls, frameless heads on nameless walls.
No one really cared about his work.
With eyes that watch
dead.
The world and can't forget, like the strangers that you've met, the ragged men in ragged clothes, a silver thorn, a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never.
Okay, so here's what's interesting about Mr. Van Gogh. He was someone Wasn't he one of the first to use the vibrant colors that many artists before him did not really use? His work was not really appreciated in his time. I would like to think his work is more appreciated now, but according to Don, maybe it isn't. Who knows? But his body of work encompasses so much. And yet he was not appreciated in his own time. And what he depicted in his paintings was people. He tried to immortalize them almost. So what Don is saying in the song is that he like tried to help the poor in the only way he knew how, by trying to set them in stone. And yet none of them thought he did anything special. Okay. All right. Let's see if Songfax has anything to add to this. All right, charted number 1 in the UK and number 12 in the United States. The words and imagery of this song represent the life, work, and death of Vincent van Gogh. A Starry Night... Okay, is the song actually called... No, it's just Vincent. A Starry Night is one of the Dutch Impressionist's most famous paintings, yes. The lyrics, paint your palette blue and gray, reflect the prominent colors of the painting and are probably a reference to Vincent's habit of sucking on or biting his paintbrushes while he worked, okay? The ragged men in ragged clothes and how you tried to set them free referred to his humanitarian activities and love of the socially outcasts as reflected in his paintings and drawings. They would not listen, they did not know refers to his family and associates who were critical of his kindness to the wretched. How you suffered for your sanity refers to the schizophrenic disorder from which Van Gogh suffered. McLean told the Daily Telegraph February 24th, 2010, the beginning of this song. In the autumn of 1970, I had a job singing in the school system, playing my guitar in classrooms. I was sitting on the veranda one morning reading a biography of Van Gogh, and suddenly I knew I had to write a song arguing that he wasn't crazy. He had an illness, and so did his brother Theo. This makes it different in my mind to the garden variety of crazy, because he was rejected by a woman. As was commonly thought. So I sat down with a print of Starry Night and wrote the lyrics out on a paper bag. McLean was going through a dark period when he wrote this song. He explained to the Daily Telegraph, I was in a bad marriage at the time, and it was torturing me. I was tortured. I wasn't as badly off as Vincent was, but I wasn't thrilled, let's put it that way. This song and Van Gogh's painting reflect what it's like to be misunderstood. He painted Starry Night after committing himself to an asylum in 1989. He wrote that night was more richly colored than the day, but couldn't go outside to see the stars when he was committed, so he painted the night sky from memory. Talking about the song on the UK show Songbook, McLean said, it was inspired by a book, and it said that it was written by Vincent's brother Theo, and Theo also had this illness, the same one Van Gogh had. So what caused the idea to let me look up what this word means. Percolate. To cause a solvent through a... What? To penetrate. Okay. Interesting. In my head was, first of all, what a beautiful idea for a piece of music, and secondly, I also had to set the record straight. He's not crazy. But then I thought, how do you do that? Again, I wanted to have each thing be different. I'm looking through the book and fiddling around, and I saw the painting. I was like, wow, just tell the story using the color, the imagery, the movement, everything that's in this painting, because that's more him than he is him. So one thing I want to say is that music is like poetry in many ways. You have wit, drama, humor, and pathos, and anger, and all these things can create the subtle tools that an artist, a stage artist, a good one, uses. Sadly, this has really gone out of music completely. So it makes someone like me a relic, because I'm doing things and people like me are doing things that utilize classic means of emotional expression. There could be some Religious meaning in the song. Starry night could mean creation, with other lyrics referring to Jesus. Okay. He has said that several songs on the American Pie album have a religious aspect to them. Well, he specifically says Vincent, so... Yeah, I don't know where they got this from, but whatever. Okay. According to the movie about Tupac, the gangster rapper Tupac Shakur was influenced by Don McLean, and this was his favorite song. All right, beautiful song. I loved it. That was a really cool song. There's a lot of cool history behind that song, and Vincent van Gogh is a very interesting artist to me, so it's really cool to hear a song from relatively not that long ago. Well, not too long ago, paying tribute to him. So for that, I salute you, Mr. McLean. And yeah, thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for spending some time with me, and if you're new to the channel, again, consider subscribing. Deathstroke 9 out. I'll see you guys soon.